Okay, so hello everyone, this is Akshay here, and today we're going to cover a question in the binary tree playlist of kth ancestor in a tree. Before starting ahead, if you're new to this channel, please like, share and subscribe and hit the bell icon to get the regular updates. So as we can see, there are two inputs and outputs given here for this particular question. So for this tree which have the nodes 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, let us assume the input given the node equals to 4 and the k equals to 2. So k equals to 2 means you need to find the second ancestor. So ancestor is nothing but the parent, right? Purvaj, in Hindi we known as call it as Purvaj, right? So for this four I'm talking about here, for this four, the first parent is 2, right? But we want the second ancestor, right? So we want like parent of parent for this k equals to 2. So the first parent is 2. Now find the parent of this 2 again and you will get 1. So this is our second ancestor of this node 4, and that is why 1 is answer. Similarly, for the second input, the node here given is 3, and we just found want to find the first answer. That is, we just want to find the first parent. The parent of 3 is 1, and definitely that 1 is our answer. How can we do this question? Please pause this video, try to think of the approach, and then we will resume again. Okay, let us resume. So what I am saying is that okay, there is one more condition here given, is that let's say for n equals to 5, you'd be given here, and the nodes will start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Similarly, n equals to 3 would be given that this tree consists 3 nodes, and the inputs would be 1, 2, and 3. Now, this thing makes this question slightly easier to code, right? So what we can do here is we already know the level order traversal, right? So I have made this video on level order traversal. It must be showing up here now in the playlist. So you must watch that video, understand how the level order traversal works, and that would be the intuition, that would be the first step for this question. So for this particular tree, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, what happens is that we have a queue here, and then we push the root node, correct? We push the root node, and then we push its children. We remove the first element from the queue, that is, we remove 1 and push its children, right? 2 and 3. Similarly, we will process 2 and we will push 4 and 5. Similarly, we will then process 3 and no further children are there, then 3 will be printed, and 4 and 5. No, the children are there, and that is why this order would be printed 1, 2, 3, and 4. So if you observe in this level order traversal, what are we doing is that for each and every node, we are pushing its children. That is, at a particular time, for each and every node, we have to handle, like we have the privilege to know what this particular node has the children, right? Kids node ke kya kya children hai, wo humare paas privilege hai. So why not while maintaining the level order traversal, hum wahan pe while pushing its children, before or after just pushing the children, why not we just maintain it? Why not we just track it in one something dear section, let's say an array, right? So now let us do the level order traversal again. So we have a queue and one is pushed, right? What I'm saying is that let's maintain an array of size n plus 1. So it would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, right? So 1 is here, right? Now what I need to push its children, correct? So I will push the children, but I will do one more thing that I will do. The children are 2 and 3, right? So I will say that the parent, this is the parent array. The parent of 2 is nothing but 1. And the parent of 3 is nothing but 1. And how can we write it in the terms of pseudocode? This one is, let's say, we have hold it in a pointer, let's say current, right? What we can write here is parent of current dot left dot data is equals to current dot data, right? Similarly, we can write for the right children as well. So parent of current dot right dot data is nothing but current dot data, right? Okay, so this will take care. So in this entry 2 and 3, one would be placed, and 2 and 3 would be pushed. Similarly, we'll process 2 again. While the queue is not empty, we will keep on processing the first element in the queue. Now 2 has the children, which one? 2 has children 4 and 5, right? So I will say that parent of 4 is equals to 2 and parent of 5 is equals to 2, and I will push its children 4 and 5, and I'll update this array. So parent of 4 is 2, parent of 5 is 2. Now 3 has it has no children, so it would just be like removing the elements and will not push any children. Similarly for 4 and 5, right? So what about this root node? This root node has no, like, it is itself the starting of the tree, does not have any parent. So let us mark this as minus 1. Now we have the track for each and every node, kiske parent kya hai, and then for that particular node, which parent is available. राइट। तो फॉर के इक्वल्स टू हम क्या करेंगे कि फॉर नोड इक्वल्स टू फोर, राइट, वी विल कम टू द इंडेक्स फोर, राइट, एंड वी नो दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू इज एक्चुअली द पेरेंट ऑफ नोड फोर, राइट। सो दिस वुड बी द फर्स्ट स्टेप, यहाँ पे वी विल जस्ट डू अ काउंट प्लस प्लस दैट वी नो द इमीडिएट पेरेंट ऑफ फोर इज टू, बट आई वॉन्ट वन मोर टाइम, राइट, बिकॉज इन केज इक्वल्स टू टू, राइट। सो नाउ आई विल गो टू द इंडेक्स टू, नाउ ड्यू टू हियर आई विल गो टू इंडेक्स टू एंड आई विल से ओके द पेरेंट ऑफ टू इज वन, right, so this here will count will give you s2, and whenever my count will be equals to k, as soon as I have done the iteration k times, I will say that this is my answer, this is the parent of this particular node is my answer, right, and as you can see, one is your answer. I hope that makes sense to you guys. Please pause this video here and I'll try to code this approach in your code editor. The problem link will be available to you in the description, so please try first and then look up to the solution. Okay, so that's the code editor given for this question. So to make an array and to do a level or a traversal, to fill the parent array first, what we need to do? We need to store the array. We need to find the size of the tree first of all. So write a helper function to find the size of a tree. After doing that, you need to make one more helper function doing for the level or traversal and fill the parent array. Do make sure to make these two functions because this is a very prerequisite type. We have already covered the how to find the size of the tree, the number of nodes in a tree, and how to do a level or traversal, and then we proceed ahead. Okay, the first and foremost thing as we discussed was to find the length of the tree. So in the length of the tree, we'll just pass the root node, and that's the helper function given. It's a very simple code that if root is null, you do not have to do anything, just stop the recursion and move and exit from the function. Else you need to traverse in the right hand side and the left hand side, and in between you need to also increment your counter. You can write root dot left first and root dot right after that, it doesn't matter. It's just that you need to increment your counter here, right? Okay, so that's it. And then we need a parent array. So we have made a parent array using this particular length function and made this a global variable num node. So that's why the updated value will be always present in here. And we have made the size as num node plus one. Then we are again calling a function fill parent that to fill this parent array. And the parameters are the root node and the parent array. Now this is nothing but a purely level order traversal code, right? If you have understood the level order traversal code and the dry run, then definitely you must not be facing any problem. It will be like a cakewalk to you. So only the changes here is that this line, line number 167 and 172 is the only change in the level of the traversal standard code. But then let me give you a code walkthrough. So the for root node, the parent value for the root node is minus one because it does not have a parent. It's the starting node of the tree. Then we made a queue. Well, while queue is not empty, we are processing each and every element, removing the first element from the queue. So we are storing that particular node in the current. And if the children is not null, in the left and right children is not null, we will be again pushing it in the queue. Simultaneously, we need to mark the parent of current dot, parent of that particular node as. So we need to mark. What is this? So we need to mark the parent of the node, right? So whatever the left and right children are coming, so we need to mark the parent of that particular node to this current dot data, because current dot data here will be the parent of this left and right children. Correct. Let us go back to the main function again. Then again, we just need to move iterate k times in our parent array, right? And we'll get an answer. And if this condition is not hitting, that if count is not getting equals to k, then definitely you must have, then your counter must have exceeded your k value. Like what I'm saying is, like this, for this particular tree, let's say k was given to you as 3, right? K was given to you as 3. So what will happen first of all? So for this 4, you will move to this 2 and your counter will say 1, right? It has incremented to 1. Then you will move to this 1 and your counter will be incremented as 2, right? But now you have hit the condition that it is the node value, the parent value of 1 is minus 1, right? So definitely you need to break it from here. So this is the stopping condition, because beyond this there is no parent available. So that is why we have a while loop, that while node not equals to minus 1, we need to do it. And we need to increment the counter as soon as it hits. So for k equals to 3, what will happen? That it will hit the base condition, it will stop, and you need to return the value. Okay. And it's written here, if there does not exist any such ancestor, then return minus 1. That is where the last we have said, return minus 1. And that is it. That's the code walkthrough for this complete code. Let us compile and run. Meanwhile, it is compiling. What is the time complexity of this code? If you see that we are just calling this length function and the fill parent function, right? So the length function will take the time complexity as O of n and space complexity as O of height of the tree. This fill parent is a level or traversal code. So it is taking O of n as time complexity and O of n as space complexity because we are using a queue. Again, we are using a parent array. So again, the space complexity will again O of n. So combining all these time complexities and this while loop iterations as well, the overall time complexity will give you as O of n because everything is in parallel work. O of n plus O of n, and this while loop will give you the worst as O of n. So O of 3n. So including the constant time complexity with O of n, the space complexity will also be O of n. So definitely, let us see the constraint as well, if n is less than 10 power 8 or not. So yes, n is less than 10 power 8, it is 10 power 5. So definitely this code will get submitted. Let's wait for the submission and then we will proceed ahead with this C++ code. Great. Okay, so that's the C++ code. So let me just scroll it through. The same code is written here and nothing is changed. I hope you'll be getting a good idea from this code as well. So the source code of these two approaches of in two of the language in Java and C++ will be mentioned in the description. And that's it. Let us hit the submit button for this code as well. Great, that code has been successfully submitted. And if you're liking the way of my problem teaching, if you're getting help, getting the intuition of this problem solved, so definitely hit the subscribe button and follow the and hit the bell icon to get the regular updates. In the meanwhile, keep learning, keep growing, and take care, guys. We'll meet again in the tomorrow's video of the tomorrow's week.